Welcome along then to France, one of the great racing meccas, host of the world-famous Tour de France, and widely thought of as giving birth to the art of motor racing in the late 1800s. How far we've come since then, as this year's race gets underway. It's time, of course, for the French Grand Prix. A lap of Paul Ricard then consists of 15 corners and a total length of around 3.6 miles. Drivers will need to position their cars carefully on the exit of the flat-out Turn 10, ready for the double apex right-hander at 11. Watch out for potential overtaking action at the end of the start-finish straight and into the heavy braking zone of Turn 8. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. An immense lap from Carlos Sainz yesterday puts him in pole position, and the rookie completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Verstappen, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Leclerc, Russell, Ocon, Ricciardo, and Lando Norris, Fernando Alonso, Magnussen, Pierre Gasly, and Mick Schumacher, Albon, Tsunoda, Lance Stroll and Valtteri Bottas, Vettel and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. It's just about time to go to the track for the beginning of the race, but before we do, Natalie Pinkham, what types of strategy do you think we can expect going into today's race?
Well, there's a lot that both driver and the team have to keep in mind when going into a race. The tyres, fuel, energy recovery system, the list goes on and on. But I think the key to today's victory will come down to the pit stop strategy. Come in too soon and you might find yourself needing more than one stop. Too late and you're putting yourself at a disadvantage by spending longer on worn tyres.
Going to be on mediums. 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. Look after these tyres now and we'll finish the race on this compound. seconds. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 2.4 seconds. Okay, so the gap to the car behind is 3.9 seconds. tenths a lap. Well done.
Another superb French Grand Prix comes to an end, and it's a thoroughly deserved victory. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they've secured here. And now, let's take a look at the driver's standings. Well, that lead at the top has somewhat shrunk today. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, Who do you pick?
Charles Leclerc showed exactly how to manage yourself out on track today. He was almost flawless out there. Incredible stuff.
Let's move on to the constructors. And pulling further ahead in the standings, it's Red Bull. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.